tuning in to the online broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. AfterBuzz TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
Hello, everyone. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV's Spotlight On. I am your host, Tony Moore, and in celebration of Days of Our Lives celebrating their 50th year this year, we are bringing back past cast members to catch up with them and find out just what has life been like since they left Salem. And I am here with the very lovable and very beautiful Miss Rachel Melvin.
That's so kind of you.
Well, I'm thank a kind you. Person.
You're lovely and beautiful as well.
Oh, thank you. And you guys remember her as Chelsea Brady. Not anymore.
No. Am I like, I feel like I'm very far away from this now.
No, I think you're good.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
The fans are like really excited. There's actually a fan because we recap audition days every Sunday at 5 p.m. And you like that plug?
I do.
I'm getting better at that.
You've always been really great at
like
everything.
Oh, thank you. Welcome. But she's like a huge fan of yours. So she's like, aww, my week is made because Rachel's there.
Oh, that's so nice.
People miss you in Salem.
Oh, well, you can see me in other places.
Well,
thankfully.
We're going to find out about all of those other places. But we're going to start off with your time on Days. Were you a fan of Days before you landed the part of Chelsea?
I was. I used to watch it in high school because of my sister.
Yeah.
And I was obsessed with Kate.
Who isn't obsessed with Kate?
She was my all-time favorite.
Yeah.
And then at the time, there was a character, Kristen, and she had her twin, Susan, I want to say.
Oh my God, I loved Susan.
Yeah, so we were very into that whole storyline. So it was really crazy when like Lauren Coslow was my grandmother.
Yeah, did that freak you out? Like the first day you're on set and you're looking at her like.
I don't know if I was ever freaked out. I think it was more of like, you know, like when you're looking through a pair of glasses for the first time and you're like, your vision's kind of trying to adjust.
Yeah.
It kind of felt like that was going on with my brain. Because
yeah.
I'm seeing all these people that I felt like I knew for so long
yeah.
and had seen every day.
Yeah.
And then now I'm actually seeing them.
Yeah.
And they're, you know, actual people that aren't their characters. It was crazy.
I get that. Because I remember my first day on mm-hmm. set doing background work.
But we've talked about this,
yeah.
though, how there'd be times when you'd be like, whoa.
Yeah. I had that moment of like, oh my gosh, like I've watched the show for years and I met many of you before
mm-hmm.
I went to set, but like standing there, I was like, this is actually happening. I'm
yeah, it's
here.
Weird.
Yeah,
it's a
really,
weird like.
Yeah. And then my second thought was like, ooh, this place is small.
Yeah. Yeah, and the sets look a lot different on television than
yeah.
they do in person.
Yeah, it's like, oh, they only walk offset when they're like walking and you seem
mm-hmm.
like they're walking to more of the house or the Brady Pub and they're just like, no, just heading to the dressing room.
Yeah, and then being there quite frequently, you would see the same pieces in different sets often. And I'd be like,
yeah.
oh, hey, there's my bed in a motel. Like, it's so funny.
So what did you enjoy about playing Chelsea, because she was kind of like a bad girl.
I feel so old right now
because
of what I'm
like
about
so
to say. It
ago.
Feels like so long ago that I'm
I
like,
know.
Oh, I was such a child. Not that I'm that much older, but I mean, I think I've been gone. I left in 2009.
Yeah.
So it's been like almost 6 years, right?
Yeah. Wait, nine?
Yes, I
yeah,
know. We're
years.
Very good at math.
Oh, yeah. Horrible.
But it feels like It feels like thinking back to high school because
yeah.
essentially that I went right from high school a year later. I was thankfully
mm-hmm.
Working on the soap.
Wow.
And so it's weird to think back because it's
yeah.
like remembering what I ate that one day, you know, at lunch in high school. But what was the question?
What was it? What was the question? What was it like to play Chelsea? Because she started off as like a bad girl.
Oh, right. I think that, you know, Chelsea was a great character for me at the time because I grew up with her. And I think, you know, and I mean that in a multitude of ways. I feel like I grew up with her as a human being, but also as an actress. And I kind of figured out who I wanted to be by figuring out what I wanted to bring to this character to try to make the horrible things she was doing redeemable. And
yeah.
I don't know if that made me as a person sound good, but regardless, I think I played her from like 19 to 24. I want to say I just turned 24.
Yeah.
And like, I always say you can't ever really know who a person is until after they turn 25.
Yeah.
I almost think that being a girl 20 to 25 is like worse than being a girl 15 to 18.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so much worse.
I mean, I wouldn't
worse.
Know for sure, but like from what I've heard, you know, it's
not,
a trying
it's
time.
It's not good, especially being in LA. I feel like you're exposed to so many things, and it's kind of like trying to figure out the person you want to be and learning from the people you're surrounded by.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like there was a lot of that in Chelsea.
Yeah.
So, you know, it worked for me professionally. But I also just remember my time on Days being like very dramatic, like Offset.
Yeah.
And I don't think I knew how to separate like, I'm going to work, I do my thing, and then I leave and I leave it behind.
Yeah.
I think it was just constantly like I was really into drama.
Yeah.
I was on a drama.
Yeah.
And it was just all drama.
So Chelsea kind of followed you Offset alone.
Oh, every day. Like every day, to the point I even dated the same people I dated on screen. Like, I don't care, this was 6 years ago now. I'm like, literally. But yeah, I think I'm a much cooler person now.
Well, I've always thought you were a cool person.
Oh,
like,
then maybe I'm just a nicer person.
you are grown up.
Thank you.
Because you know, when you're 19 to 24,
you're still trying
to figure things out. You know, I'm still trying to figure things out at my age. I'm like,
way cooler things. You're I feel like you're trying to genuinely figure out who you are because it interests you and you want to be the best you can be, whereas when you're younger you're trying to be who you think everyone wants you to be because you want to be cool.
Yeah. I don't know if I ever wanted to be cool.
I always wanted to be cool.
Really?
All the time.
I always marched to the beat of my own drum.
Oh,
so.
I did that too. I just did it with the intention of wanting to be very cool and not understanding why I wasn't.
Well, speaking of being cool, Chelsea was not very cool during her time in Salem.
With the killing the baby?
Well, there was a lot of killings and a lot of
remind
drugging.
Me what I did.
Let's see. So, brief rundown from what I remember, and I kind of looked it up because I had to remember.
Of course.
So, you drugged Patrick Lockhart because you
were that was really fresh.
So in love with him. Yeah. You also ran over Zach.
That one I remember.
And Billy took your mom took the blame for you. You were upset to find out that your parents weren't your parents, that Bo and Billy were actually your parents. You hid Ford Decker's body, the guy who was
that,
like,
I have
drugging
to say,
everyone.
Was like my favorite storyline.
Was it really?
I loved doing all the sorority stuff. I never went to college. I certainly was never in a sorority, and I doubt I would have been. But just, I think, having that new energy on set of people popping in and out. Because I don't remember that really being, I don't know if things have changed now, but I don't remember that being like a very frequent thing. Like it wasn't, we'd have a guest star, so to speak, come for a day, but not like people that were recurring. And Shelley Hennig and I got to sit in on the castings, which was really cool. Mm-hmm. And I just really liked working with all of those girls. I thought it was really fun, and it felt very like, I don't know. It felt fun and goofy, but serious. I don't know. There were a lot of good storylines around that time too.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. That was a very interesting time. I, during that time though, was kind of in and out of Days. Like I would kind of catch it, but then I would kind of miss it. And then
really?
I would come back into it.
That was like the one time I wanted to watch the most.
I think I caught the tail end of the Ford Decker storyline. Like I didn't see like a lot of the beginning of it, but I caught like the middle towards the end of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, what happened to him?
Well, you can tune in at any time and know what's going on.
That's true. And it's like every day you repeat yourself. You're like, so the guy Ford Decker who's going around drugging everyone and raping them.
That was the hardest part of my job on that show.
Yeah.
Well, I just in that genre. I would say is like the dialogue, you know, I think because I came on so early and it was like one of the first things I did, I didn't know any different. So learning the dialogue just happened for me. The way it did. But having to repeat the same thing, but slightly different for like 5 days in a row became very confusing and difficult and very frustrating.
Oh, I bet.
But, you know, it was what it was.
And how was it for you? Especially like, was this like your first like big like acting job that you booked? And then
I think all I had done prior was like, I guess star in a couple WB shows at the time, which would now be the CW.
Yeah.
Jack and Bobby and Summerland. Summerland was my first job ever.
Yeah.
All my stuff got cut, but I got my SAG card. And then I think that was it.
Yeah.
No, because I played, you know, Georgia with that amazing French accent.
Okay, so I actually
I'm way better at accents now.
You are.
For sure. But don't ask me to do any because I have to prepare.
I actually remember when you played Georgia and you had like the long, like dark, like brown hair.
That was my virgin hair. I'd never colored it.
Yeah. And like, and then I remember you then coming back as like Chelsea.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, did they pick up where they left off, or is she supposed to be someone completely different?
I was supposed
to
be someone completely different. But the casting director, Fran Boscombe, at the time, she liked me for some reason. I don't know what she saw in me, because I look back to when I first started and I was like, I was the worst actress ever.
Well,
I just was like very green. I had no idea what I was doing.
Well, obviously you knew what you were doing because you did a fantastic job as Chelsea.
Thanks. I mean, I wasn't looking for a compliment, but I'll take it.
No, I mean, listen, you might not have been looking for it, but I wanted to give you one to reassure you that I've always thought you were a fantastic actress.
I don't feel like I really started to get interested enough to grow until Blake Bares came onto the show. He made me very excited about the real world of acting.
Yeah, because Blake is, so we had him.
Well, he went to like UCA film school and all that other stuff. And I was like, oh my God, you're so smart and experienced.
I want to learn from you.
I got a full ride to ASU, which I was very proud of at the time. And I've learned like they're so easy to get and it's a joke of a school. So.
Oh.
Yay for me.
Yay. Well, at least you went to the School of Days of Our Lives.
My college because I was there for 4 years.
Yeah. Who else did you enjoy working with? Because you worked with so many different people. You worked with Blake. You worked with Darren Brooks.
Blake is by far my favorite.
Yeah.
Followed closely by Julie.
And you know what's funny? I believe.
And Peter.
He said the same thing about you when he was here.
I keep rubbing my jaw because I have a headache and it's just like here and here and I'm sorry.
That was good.
Okay, sorry.
But
you were saying that people like me.
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
When we had Blake on, I asked him who did he enjoy working with, and he was like you. He was like, you took him by the hand and showed him the ropes and like
me?
Yeah.
It was so backwards.
If my memory serves me correctly. Someone's going to probably correct me.
It's possible your memory's failing you.
No, I'm almost pretty sure. You know what? Now I'm going to take if you guys who are in the chat room now, if you remember my spotlight on with Blake, let me know who his favorite person was, if it was Rachel, because I'm pretty sure I'm right. I'm going
to
actually
Well, Blake and I are very good friends, so he may have felt obligated to say my name.
You're a very likable person. They like you. They really like you.
Really like me. That's very kind.
Speaking of liking you, we do have our live chat up, and I know some people have some questions. We do have one from Daquan, who is a fan of our show. He asked, what was your favorite part about playing Chelsea Brady?
This is going to sound so silly. I liked her clothes. I liked her clothes the most. My favorite part of the day was going in for my fitting in the morning.
Did you get to keep the clothes? Like, once you left?
No.
No?
No. We weren't supposed to keep the clothes.
Okay, let me rephrase this. Because, you know, it's so long ago. No one cares. Did you keep clothes of Chelsea Brady?
I borrowed some mementos that I wanted to have in my life for the duration of my existence.
Because I feel like when a character leaves, like, they can't do anything with those clothes. They can't put them on someone else.
Not that I know of. I mean, you're not supposed to take them. A lot of people do.
Yeah.
But then if you need, you need to hang on to them in case they need them back.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I brought a couple things back, actually. But yeah. What else did I like about... I liked the fact that she I mean, to me, seemed like, despite all of obviously the expositional things that were happening to her, I felt like she genuinely, she was written very well. She had a lot of emotion and a lot of inner conflict that I think most young women do.
Yeah.
And I think she made a lot of mistakes, as most young women do, most people in general. It doesn't have to be women.
Yeah.
Women make less mistakes than men, let's be real. totally kidding. Most of the mistakes we make are men. But did that answer the question?
Yes.
Okay, good.
I
talk a lot, so I'm trying to cut myself
No, this is totally fine, because I just sit here and listen, and then I think of my next question. So this is perfect.
Great.
So it's like, it almost alleviates the pressure off of me, because I can just listen
to
you.
So essentially you're not really listening, though.
I am listening. I'm
it's
hanging.
Okay, you can multitask.
Yeah, I'm hanging. Look, I can listen to
it's
you.
A, it's a good
I can
thing
think
we're
of my
friends.
Question.
Like, we know how
I know.
To deal
See,
with
well,
this.
Yeah, I totally know how to interact with you and deal with you.
We sound so LA.
Oh, no, don't
totally,
say that.
Totally, yeah. So, oh my God, for sure, for
Oh
real.
My God, did you take the 405 to get here?
I don't like the Californians.
You don't like the Californians?
I don't know why. I mean, I get it. It's funny, but like,
I giggle every time, because I giggle because they're giggling. Like, they lose it whenever they
yes,
come in and do
that
it.
That is the
so
funniest
then it makes
thing.
Me laugh.
Yeah, I think maybe I'm just bitter I'm not in New York.
Yeah, are you more of a New Yorker than...
No, I've realized I used to be more of a New Yorker, and this is what I tell people now. I like the mentality of New York with the lifestyle of LA.
Yeah.
I just wish the people in LA were more like the people in New York. You know.
I mean, if we talked about that,
we'd be here forever.
Yeah, we totally would. Leah Mulder has a question, and she wants to know, what have you been doing since you left Days? You've been doing a lot. Because there was a Lifetime movie that I saw.
Oh, yeah. There was a Lifetime movie. I just to recap briefly, right after Days, I did like a recurring guest star in Heroes, which was great.
Mm-hmm.
Then I did the Lifetime movie. Then I did, which was called Seven Deadly Sins. and then I did a guest star in House. And when I did House, that was when my aunt died. Of stage one lung cancer after they took her out of ICU too soon because she didn't have insurance. Not saying that that's a bad thing for her. I just think it's really messed up at the hospital. But so when all that happened, I think that was like the third death in 3 years of people like under 60 that had died in our family. So I just went through like this weird period of feeling like what I did for a living was really stupid and there are bigger things to like focus on. And I just felt like a stupid person. I don't know how else to describe it. It was very weird. And I've never had anyone die in my life. The majority of them that had passed away died before I was like old enough to understand what it really meant, which I'm fortunate of, but it made this a lot more difficult. And so I think I was dating a sociopath. He legitimately was a sociopath. I was just in like a really bad place. And my heart just wasn't in it. So then I didn't really work for a while. And then I like worked on like, you know, little independent films. And then I think like I got my mojo back, so to speak, with Zombeavers, which by the way is on DVD and Blu-ray now and Netflix. So go get it.
Bing!
it's really stupid funny. It should be a comedy.
Yes.
They're calling it a horror comedy. It's more a comedy
more
than a horror. but and that's where I met my amazing boyfriend that I've been with ever since.
Yes.
And then...
I remember this because that was one of the times we hung out. I was going through my stuff and you had just met.
I was going through my stuff. I've been very open about my stuff on this episode.
You have, which is new for you.
Is that new for me?
I don't know.
Am I a guarded individual?
I think
I'm just
guarded.
Like, I turned 30 and I'm like.
Yeah, you're just kind of like, I'm just going to do me now.
Yeah.
No, but that's good though.
Yeah.
I think once you hit 30, you're just kind of like. If you haven't figured yourself out already, you're figuring yourself out. But in the meantime, you're just kind of like, whatever. Like
I think you just get over yourself.
Yeah.
I think I just got over myself.
Yeah.
I was like, you know, and then I was just like, Taylor Swift made it cool to be like an outcast and a weirdo nerd, emotional wreck. So I was like, I'm just going to love me.
Yes.
No, and then after Zombeavers, I think like the next thing of note would have been Dumb and Dumber. Was that the same year? That was the same year.
Yeah.
Yeah, I shot Zombeavers of like 9 months before Dumb and Dumber. And Dumb and Dumber came about because I went to a commercial audition when Tim and I were fighting on the West Side during rush hour traffic, which otherwise I would have not gone to, but I wanted to get out of the house. Blah, blah, blah. I went to this commercial and Rick Montgomery was casting the commercial and he's the casting director for most of the Farrelly Brother movies. And so he brought me in for Dumb and Dumber. And then that whole thing happened. And then I love that I'm like, it's like with negative connotation, that whole thing, that amazing thing happened. And then after that, why can't I remember my life? Oh, I just did a little movie in Illinois called The Rake, which is like a practical effect movie a la like Predator, Alien.
Yeah.
And now I am, this is going to be on the season of Awkward, which I'm very excited about.
Yes.
And that's it. That brings us up to date. And now you know my resume.
So, I mean, I feel like for some people, life after days can be rocky.
I'm sorry. I did a really great movie called Madtown. I can't, and Sleepwalker. Oh my God. I've worked way more than I thought.
You've been doing stuff.
No, Sleepwalker it's a really cool, like, suspense psychological thriller. I can't wait for it to come out. It's with Ahna O'Reilly and the director of this Nightingale that's on HBO.
Okay, yeah.
And I apologize, I don't know more about the Nightingale. And then Madtown I did with Milo Ventimiglia, who love. And hopefully that'll be coming out in like the next 12 months. That was a really cool, like, dark indie piece. And I play like a really quirky weirdo who I have to sing, and singing is like my biggest fear. So I apologize if you see it and I sound horrible. I was very nervous.
I'm pretty sure you sound fine. You used to take voice lessons, didn't you?
It's so awkward. Look, it's very different in my car and like in front of people. Okay? Like, I'm the person, like, if there's traffic, I'll stop singing. I just don't want people to see me singing. And I don't know why. I don't know why I'm this way. It's so silly.
I'm the person that I lip sing in the car.
What's the difference?
But I mean, when you're lip singing, you're not hearing yourself. You're hearing the person. So you feel like you sound great.
This is so funny. My sister always tries to turn up the music so she doesn't hear herself sing. And I was like, no, turn it down. I want to make sure I'm getting this note right.
And sometimes you can feel when you don't get the note right. And do you rewind it back to try to get the note?
I've done that.
I
listened to All Too Well by Taylor Swift like 7 times on the way here, stuck in traffic. It's like, I'm going to get this crescendo note. And I finally figured out how to do it. I feel very accomplished for the day.
See, that's what happens when you're in LA traffic. You know, you find things to do and things to work on.
It's true. I generally don't mind traffic because I like my car. It's a very comfortable, you know, space.
Yeah.
I like singing. It's the only time now that I live with someone that I can actually sing. And by the way, like, you know what I think why I don't like to sing in front of people? There's been 3 times I was singing a Broadway song when I was driving with my parents, like belting it out in the backseat. My dad turned it down randomly because he wanted to hear me sing, and I felt so violated. And then I lived with my friend Jill, and I didn't know she was at home, and I'm like busting out singing in my iPod, and I do still have an iPod. And all of a sudden, I see, like, the bathroom light on in her bathroom, and I was like, I take my earbud out, and I'm like, Jill? She's like, yeah? No! And then my boyfriend did it to me the other day when I was singing Taylor Swift, because that's all I listened to.
Yes.
And he was like, oh, I enjoyed the concert. I was like, you're a jerk.
It's okay. That's happened to me many a times. I sing in the shower. Because, like, the acoustics in the bathroom are really good.
I don't sing in the shower. That's
I do.
Weird.
I will
belt. That I don't, I mean.
I belt out, like, Beyonce, Broadway tunes, whatever I'm feeling. And I usually do, like, a mix. Like, I go from one song to, like, the other.
Ooh, impressive.
Yeah, yeah. And usually I feel like I'm at the house by myself. And then I get out of the shower and I'm realizing. Yeah, and I'm just like, yeah. I even think I belted out Let It Go at some point in time.
Oh, I hate that song.
I still
it's not that
love
I don't
it.
Hate it.
It's overplayed.
Or it's not that I hate it. Yeah, yeah. I'm so over it. I never even got under it.
Yeah.
And it didn't do anything for me.
Someone wanted to know if you are still painting.
Oh yeah, I painted today.
Yeah. I know that used to be like your time, your stress reliever.
Oh yeah. So I draw and I paint when I'm really stressed out because it takes up so much of my focus that I can't think about stupid things that should be bothering me that are.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing and a bad thing because I don't draw very often.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can see I used to draw like multiple times during the year and be like, wow, you were really stressed out or bothered.
Yeah.
I don't think I've drawn in like 3 years. It's crazy. Although I did doodle for my first time, which is the owl on my Spotted Owl blog. I doodled.
Yes.
I feel like maybe I'm really far away. No. And I'm not, you know, my problem with art is that I'm not imaginative. I draw still life because yeah. I'm not imaginative.
Yeah. Well,
which is a very like amazing juxtaposition for my profession. But, but I'm painting now. I'm, doing like decor. Like home decor yeah. with like chalk paint, which I'm obsessed with. It just started.
Tell us about the your blog, Spotted Owl. Someone else wanted to know about
so
that.
So the Spotted Owl's kind of been down for a while because I've been working so much, which is great.
Yeah.
But I have written blogs, I just haven't posted them. So actually, while I've been in my trailer on Awkward, I've been editing them and stuff like that. And I'm kind of revamping the site. I've created a website for me as a professional actress, and the blog will now actually just be a blog that's focused on whatever I want to write about.
Yeah.
And then like home stuff that I make, and then like thrift stuff that I find, because I yeah. really love my friend said this to me one time and it's just really stuck with me. She was like, I've always loved recycling, but she said, you know, I hate buying new things because I feel like I'm contributing to the waste of the world when yeah. there's like old things you can just make new.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's so cool. And you know, when I came up with this Spotted Owl originally, I'm like spoiling a blog that I just wrote yesterday that I'm gonna post, but spotted means like tarnished, torn, ripped, tattered,
yeah.
and then owl is to imply wise. So for me, the blog was always supposed to be like me being wise, so to speak, of like yeah. writing about my contemplations in life. If that's a word, I don't really know. I think I may have made it up. but you know what I mean.
Yeah.
And then the spotted stuff was supposed to be like, you know, trash that I find. Like I literally dumpster dive for like wood pieces, and then I refurbish them and flip them, and then the clothing, I love shopping at Goodwill. I'm really good at it. It's a
you know,
really weird talent.
You can find some really good stuff at the Goodwill.
I'm like, I don't even feel conceited saying this.
Yeah.
Like, I am so good at it.
There are some expert Goodwill shoppers. I tend to find stuff like every blue moon, but like
a lot of people do. So
yeah.
So what I'm doing now is I, you know, again, I'm not going to give too much away for this blog post that I have, but because I don't want to make it be for nothing.
Yeah.
I spent a lot of time writing it yesterday.
Yeah.
Just kidding. Kind of. I just want to feature like the fashion thing. I just feel like so many blogs are focused on like trying to get you to spend money you don't have.
Mm-hmm.
And they're really targeted at people that have a certain income. And let's be honest, like most people don't. I probably have way less money than you suspect I do. So it's like, so I'm constantly thrifting. And
yeah.
I think like there are so many cool things that, by the way, like things back in the day were made so much better anyway, the
yeah.
quality.
Yeah.
So I'm just now going to be featuring like finds that I find at Goodwill, and then occasionally like I find so many things I already have or things that I love that aren't in my size. So now I'm just going to be featuring them in photos and then eventually putting them up for sale if people want to get them at affordable prices.
Yeah.
Just because it's like one of a kind and you'll never be able to find it again. But like I have friends and I love like embracing all body types, and I have friends of all body types. And
yeah.
so everyone's going to be modeling them and it'll be really fun.
See, that I always find it very interesting when people are able to find like stuff at the Goodwill and they're able to like utilize it in some or clean it up some way and like make it look better or cool. Like I can't do that.
I have actually, there's a post on my blog already about how to Goodwill shop. It's
yeah.
so much simpler than you suspect. And a lot of this, because a lot of the stuff that ends up there doesn't end up there because it's broken, ripped, or torn.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times people, it's so amazing. I found like this really amazing pair of boots that people weren't even trying on because there was a knot in the lace. And like, I suspect that's why they donated them. And
yeah.
I'm like, buy new laces. I
yeah,
mean, what?
Exactly. Like, why get rid of the boot?
But people are, you know, they
right.
don't think that way all the time. So,
I'm like a hoarder. I keep stuff. I think I'm pretty sure I have shirts that I wore in college / maybe senior year of high school.
I am the polar opposite of a hoarder. I'm a chronic disposer.
Really? So you're like my mom. Like
oh,
my,
see, and I'm the opposite of my mom.
Like, my mom will, like, go through and just, like, wipe stuff out. And she's like, if you don't need this, throw it away. Like, here, you don't need
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I can't stand stuff.
Yeah, I like to keep stuff. Because I'm always like, oh, no. I mean, I kept, like, I'm pretty sure I still have this at my house in South Carolina. All of my notebooks from, like, high school
and college.
Oh, no,
you keep
college.
Those forever.
Well, yeah. Because,
that's different.
But this is why I kept them because I said, one day I'll be a huge star and someone will want to know that I made an A on this paper.
Aw, that's amazing. I love that.
I kept my pillow from like second grade when I learned how to cross stitch. Like, there's stuff like that, but there's a part of me that's like, you really could get rid of this stuff. Like,
no, I mean, if it's like sentimental, I remember one of my first jobs was at this place called As You Wish, which mm-hmm. was a pottery, which is a pottery painting place in Phoenix, Arizona, mm-hmm. and several other places across the state, but or cities across the state. Mm-hmm. But it's kind of similar to a Color Me Mine that they have out here.
Oh yeah.
But way better.
Yeah.
Because it was independently owned, not a chain.
Yeah.
Very pro mom and pop shop, but. I loved that job, and one of the things they had a star plate, and one of the things I did was I made my own Hollywood star with my handprints. I made a twofer. So I put my handprint on it, and then I put like my name, and then I signed it. I still have it.
I wish I had one of those.
I'll make you one.
Oh, thanks.
It'll be way better because I'm older now.
Someone wanted to know, I think it was Sarah Yu, who's also a big fan of our recap show. She wanted to know what your favorite Taylor Swift song is.
All Too Well, hands
All
down.
Too Well?
Yeah, it's my favorite.
You know, oh my gosh.
She's got so many. Though.
She does.
My all-time.
I was always kind of a fan of Taylor's, but I think it wasn't until Red that I was like,
yes.
Okay, yeah.
Samesies.
Like I'm getting you.
Yeah, like we dated the same person. And yeah. I listened to that and I was like, oh my God, this girl gets me.
I Knew You Were Trouble. Ooh, I used to blast that.
Yeah, yeah.
All the time. And right now I'm kind of feeling Bad Blood.
I didn't like it until the video. That was my least favorite song.
The video? Okay.
So on that album.
I bought the album. It sat in my house under Beyonce's album for like ever.
See, we would be flopped.
I know. But I finally cracked it open once I saw the video for Bad Blood. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, I need to listen to this song again.
You know why it sounded cooler is because they turned up the bass, so it's more dubsteppy.
Oh.
And also, forgive me for not knowing that rapper's name, but when I was working on Awkward, one of the girls told me, she was like,
Kendrick Lamar. Is that him?
Yeah, sounds right.
Yeah, yeah.
She was like, Taylor doesn't even sing in that. I was like, yeah, she does. And I went back and I watched it and she's like, she really doesn't. She only does the chorus and the bridge.
Yeah.
But I didn't mind it for that song.
Yeah, but on the CD, she does sing
Correct.
It all the way through.
Correct.
But like the video, she just—I mean, it was a collaborative
Look,
effort.
She's hot, and she looks good as a redhead.
Listen, if I could make money off of writing songs on situations and relationships that I've been in, I would be rich, if not richer than Taylor Swift. Just saying.
I just had to recap to someone the other day, like all the relationships I'd had, and writing them out was a very awakening moment.
You're learning about life. Yourself.
Well, I'm learning to pretend I'm not the person I used to be. Well, I was never the person that I was at some point. I'm like, I just disowned her.
I am not her anymore.
No.
You know what I didn't know that I just... when I was doing some research, because I like to, you know, be a professional.
It's good.
I didn't know that you were on Family Feud.
Yeah, my sister was obsessed with the show and she forced me against my will. That's how that went. I was like, I can't. I'm on Days. People will think it's unfair and weird. She's like, who cares? I'm a teacher. I need money. So we went and we lost. Well, we won and then we lost fast money because the questions were stupid. They were stupid. It was like name the most popular fruit, which could be anything.
Apple.
I would say strawberry. My point exactly. Like, it could be anything. And then like so then we played again and then we lost, which sucked hard because we got like all the answers except for the last one that they stole,
which was
library, and we hate libraries.
Yeah.
Now.
Oh,
it was like name a place where you'll get in trouble for being loud. Library. And that was the number. Well, that was the number one answer. And you know that because I just said it. It's not that easy. But look, we got everything else other than that.
Game shows are always easy when you're sitting watching it. But like when you're in it, you're like,
I'm only good at them if it's like sexual. Like literally the only two questions that I got the number one answers for were like sexual related. Like name the number one thing that guys think about. I'm like, sex. Ding, ding, ding.
Got it.
That's all I'm good at.
So many people want to know, going back to Days, because you have been mentioned a few times.
I have not been approached.
You haven't?
No.
Would you, If you were approached, would you go back?
I don't know. It would depend on the contract.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm so happy with how things have been going. I keep talking about Awkward. Like, this is one of my favorite characters I've ever played, and I'm so excited to be doing comedy, and like comedy that's really my kind of comedy and my kind of character. And it's weird to think about going back to being sad all the time, which is how I associate being on the soap.
Well, I mean, you listen, Chelsea struggled throughout her whole time that she was there.
Yeah, but I mean, she's way older and matured now, and it would be interesting to see the kind of person that she's become.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm not opposed to anything. It just depends where I'm at when it's brought to me and what makes sense with what my big picture plan is.
Yeah.
I mean, I've said this before, like, the longer I've been off days, the more I appreciate having been on it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just, like, so I'm so grateful for the opportunity that I had. I had a lot of really fun times on that show.
Yeah. What's like, the best memory of days that you have? If there is
just one. I loved making out with Blake. We always talk about this. We were just like, there was one time, I'm really being very freaking candid today. There was one time we were doing this scene, and like, when you kiss, you don't use tongue. Like, right. It's a respect and courtesy thing.
Yeah.
We got like so in the moment, like it just kind of happened on accident. And literally, if you watch back the scene, which I can't remember the episode, but he and I both went, like, we pulled away and we're like, oh my God, we had this moment. We were like, oh my God, I'm so sorry, but that was really good. And so we talked about it after, and it was like, that's why we ended up dating. He's a very good kisser.
Listen, it was the slip of the tongue, and then you.
He's also just like the coolest person ever.
He is. Blake is a very cool, like, chill guy. Like,
yeah. Well, I mean, I definitely think that. I definitely think he just impacted my life so much professionally.
Yeah.
That I think that. I loved all the Chelsea and Nick stuff. And I loved when he got weird, because I thought that how cool for Blake to play. He loves playing like kind of twisted, demented, you know, material.
Yeah.
And then what else did I like? I liked the sorority stuff, which I said, and I can't remember much else. So that must be my favorite.
Do you still keep in touch with a lot of other people besides Blake? I know you keep in touch with Blake.
I mean, Blake is someone that I consider to be like one of my best friends.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I talk to Martha quite often. She is one of my best friends too. I just haven't talked to her in a while because, you know, people have babies and then you come second. So, so I just haven't seen her in a while. And then Shelly, I talk to you occasionally. And that's about it. I want to say.
Yeah.
I can't remember. I see Christian Alfonso out all the time.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Yeah.
I'm going to feel really bad if there's like, you know.
You're going to, well, after this, you'll probably get a text that was like, hello.
Yeah, what about me? I know.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll just go through my contacts.
Just go through the...
I'm just kidding.
Oh, yeah, this person right here. So, I'm just looking at the chat to see what fans are saying. Our Melvin fan, who is obviously your biggest fan,
could be my father's.
She says Blake has great lips. I don't blame you, girl.
He does. He's got really pretty eyes as well. Blake's an attractive guy. That's why he was on the soap.
Right. I mean, you have to be very attractive to be on a soap.
Not always.
I'm almost afraid to ask who, but that's okay.
Are you kidding me? Blake and I joke all the time. We're like the epitome of what you don't cast on a soap.
You guys are both very attractive people.
We are not universally attractive. We are genre attractive. I don't even know if genre is the right word. We're specific.
Your own unique,
like January Jones. Everyone will be like, January Jones is beautiful. You can't argue that. Evangeline Lilly, beautiful. Can't argue that. Some people are not going to like me. Some people are not going to like Blake. We're specific.
Well, let's take a poll. How many of you guys are who are currently in the chat room
Blake Bears
and Rachel Melvin are very, very attractive people? Okay. I'm going to take the next few minutes. Don't be weird about it, because that's what
our fans are for.
No, don't be. Listen, this is called the reminder check-in confidence booster to let you know. Because hearing it from me, it's just kind of like, you're my friend, you're supposed to say that. But but I'm gonna That's get you funny. Some I'm gonna get you some reassurance.
Thanks, Tony.
You're welcome. Someone asked, what about Molly Burnett?
I don't really talk to Molly that much.
No?
No, I think we bonded on set, but I don't know. We didn't really keep in touch.
She was just in a few weeks ago.
Was she? How is she?
She's great. She did a small stint on Days that's mm-hmm. about to come to a close. You know, that's like the new thing now. People are like coming on for a little bit and then they're going back out.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think that's why a lot of people are wondering if they'll see Chelsea. At some
Maybe
point
a different one, not me so far.
So what do you think, because the last we saw, Chelsea moved to London with Max.
Yeah, and then didn't he come back?
I think maybe.
Oh no, he went to Bold and the Beautiful.
Yeah. He came back, but to a different soap.
Right.
So what do you think, if you could recreate Chelsea and write her right now, like what do you think she's doing in London?
Well, I think her and Max have to be broken up, or he got plastic surgery and looks completely different. Maybe he got into a race car accident.
Because they do that all the time on soaps.
So let's go with that, because that seems more appropriate and interesting.
Yeah.
So, you know what I would like to see Days do, just because it occurred to me?
Yeah.
It'd be fun for like Chelsea to come back and be like, Max and I broke up. I'm so sad. I'm 30. I want to be married and have babies, because that would be challenging for me, because that's not necessarily something I'm like dying for.
Yeah.
And then she'd be like, I'm going to go on The Bachelorette or Bachelor. And then they have like a mock Bachelor. I think that'd be so fun.
That would be new, because they've never done like a show.
It's a perfect platform to like kind of jokingly mock The Bachelor, but like at the same time it's a soap, so it works. You know? Oh, that'd be so fun.
That would be fun. I am an advocate on getting myself a part on the show, so I have fans doing hashtag Maxine Sun, and Maxine is like a nurse.
Is she back?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
She's there. Yeah. So good. We're on the hashtag Maxine Sun campaign, and every week I usually come up with a different storyline.
Oh my God, that's great. That's so ambitious. I feel very lazy.
No, don't, because I come up with them on the spot. Like the last one I came up with was, there appears to be a lot of there's no politically correct way to say this. There are a lot of whores in Salem,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of them have worked under Stefano. So I figured Maxine was like the head, like madam of them,
mm-hmm.
and she got pregnant with Stefano's baby,
mm-hmm.
and I went away, but now I've come back to find her, and then I find out that I'm Stefano's son.
That seems very plausible.
I mean, I'm just saying.
I'm not even being sarcastic. I'm not. I have like, sometimes I just really go into Kardashian mode, and I just have no inflection, and I'm like, that's so funny.
That's hot.
But I don't laugh at all. But I'm being genuine.
So after taking a poll.
Oh, God, really?
There are a lot of yeses.
Thanks, guys. Thanks so much.
Leah Mulder said, I think Blake is cute, and Rachel, you're beautiful.
That's really nice. That's really nice.
Blake and Rachel are both perfect.
Even with my jaw, it's so crooked.
And then some people have said, I want Chelsea to come back and Max.
And be on The Bachelorette?
I'm pretty sure they would be open to anything. Someone just asked, would you like to write an episode for Days?
That's so funny, because I was just thinking of that as you said that. When I was and I didn't say anything?
Yeah.
I was just going to say, what I was thinking is, I'm like, I was about to say, I'm not good at writing, but I am good at writing, so maybe I'm just like not good at writing soaps? Because I was like, well, I don't even know what storyline I would do.
Well,
maybe I'm just not applying myself, which is very possible, because it's
Rachel
like
Melvin. You need to apply yourself.
I'm off the clock. Which I'm not even on a clock. But anyway,
you're just being you right now, chatting with little old me.
Which is probably like when I'm with my friends, I feel the most lazy. because I can be. And I'm just like, what do you want to do? You want to eat popcorn and like watch The Bachelorette? I'm really on The Bachelorette right now. I'm just so happy it wasn't Britt. Because let's be honest, she's like a waitress in Hollywood. She's like not probably really looking to settle down.
Well, I mean, let's... Is anyone on these shows actually really looking to settle down?
I think that some people are.
The only people
that... You can tell.
The only people that I believe are looking to settle down are the people on Married at First Sight.
I don't even know what that is.
You haven't seen that?
No.
It's where these people get married and they haven't seen each other until they're about to get married.
No. That would not work.
But they like... But they do like all these like tests and like things, and on paper they're supposed to be like the perfect match. And they get married and they're like, figure it out. But what
about chemistry? You need chemistry, especially if you're going to have children.
Well,
just saying.
I mean, true. But like, for the most part, it seems to kind of be working for some of them.
Well, it's television.
I don't know.
It's just how it was edited.
Maybe. I don't know. But I will admit, for 2 seconds, I looked up casting for that show. I was like, I give it a whirl.
Oh, sure. You always explore the option. I've thought about it. I was like, dude, if I was on The Bachelor, I'd be like the most real chick. And that's why I would never be on The Bachelor. I think about it. I thought about it. I'm
thought
very happy
it.
With
well,
her with now.
Maybe if they bring Chelsea back from London, then you can live out your Bachelorette dreams on that show.
Yeah. I think that'd be fun.
Yeah. I mean, why not?
This is very stimulating conversation.
I mean, it is. I'm having a good time, and everyone else is too. So, but unfortunately, we have to wrap it up. I want to thank you guys for tuning in and catching up with Rachel Melvin.
Yes, thank you for caring enough about me to care.
The people do care. I mean, listen, when you're mentioned on the show, people are like, oh my God, is she coming back? They look you up. They like want to know, and they wouldn't mind seeing you back on the show.
That's really nice, you guys.
People still care.
I appreciate it.
About Chelsea.
Thank you very much.
Even though you killed a whole bunch of people and ran over Zach, like, we're still good. We've gotten over that.
You've forgiven me.
You have, all has been forgiven.
It's a really big forgiveness.
Yes. But thank you once again
thank
for
you.
Joining me today. And thank you guys for tuning in. And make sure you check out Audition Days every Sunday at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, where myself, Peter, and Mark give you a full rundown of each week's episode of Days of Our Lives. We will see you next time for another AfterBuzz TV Spotlight On. Bye.
I'm sorry.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.